JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 21st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against most of the other major currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained only versus GBP, while it was found virtually unchanged against NZD. The main gainers were Aussie, CHF and JPY. Now, the weakening of the US dollar and the strengthening of the Aussie suggest that the markets may have traded in a risk-on manner yesterday and today in Asia. However, the relative strength of the safe havens, yen and franc, combined with the weakening of the Kiwi and the pound, points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the performance of the equity world. Now, here we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of red, with the negative appetite rolling into the Asian session today. Chinese and South Korea's markets remained closed due to holidays. Many indices tumbled more than 2% yesterday, and the reason may have been warnings by Chinese regulators that Evergrande's $305 billion worth of liabilities could result in risks to the broader financial system if its debts are not stabilized. Evergrande, China's most in-depth developer, has to pay $83.5 million in interest relating to its March 2022 bond on Thursday, while it has another $47.5 million payment due on September 29th for March 2024 notes. If it fails to settle the payments within 30 days of the scheduled dates, both bonds would default. So, with no signs of a possible solution on the horizon, we see the case for the default risks to continue growing and keep adding pressure to the broader risk appetite. In other words, we expect the Evergrande saga to continue weighing on the broader risk sentiment. Another factor that may be weighing on risk sentiment may be investors adopting a cautious stance ahead of tomorrow's FOMC monetary policy decision, with several policymakers expressing desire to start tapering their quantitative easing purchases before the end of the year. It would be interesting to see whether such a view is shared among the majority of committee members, and whether we will get any hints on when the process will start. Anything suggesting that tapering could start in November may result in a rebound in the US dollar and further declines in equities. Earlier tapering may also mean earlier rate hikes, and higher rates mean expensive borrowing for firms, as well as lower present values. Now, the Kiwi failed to capitalize against the US dollar, as it came under some selling interest after the RBNZ published a speech by Assistant Governor Christian Hogesby, saying that amid uncertainty and when risks are evenly balanced, central banks globally tend to follow a smoother path and keep their policy rate unchanged or move in 25 basis point increments. This weighed on hopes of a 50 basis point increase at the RBNZ's upcoming gathering. In our view, such a reaction suggests that a 25 basis point hike is more than priced in, and therefore, even if the bank proceeds with such a move, it would need something beyond that to support the QE, perhaps a steeper than anticipated future rate path. Now, as for today's events, during the Asian session, the RBA released the minutes from its latest policy gathering, but as we have been anticipating, they passed largely unnoticed. There was no new information in the minutes. It was just confirmed that the central scenario remains that rate increases will not happen until 2024. We also had the results of the Canadian elections, with Trudeau's Liberal Party returning to power with a minority government. With the parliament composition also expected to be nearly the same as before the election, we expect market participants to leave the event behind them and stay more focused on the Evergrande saga and developments surrounding monetary policy. Later in the day, the only data releases worth mentioning are the US building permits and housing starts for August, as well as the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. Building permits are forecast to have slid somewhat, but housing starts are expected to have inched slightly up. As for the API report, as it is always the case, no forecast is available. As for the speakers, we have two on the agenda, and those are ECB President Christine Lagarde and ECB Supervisory Board Chair Andrea Enria. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.